各位小伙伴 ，Let's Google the Little Mermaid Ariel。我们先来百度一下小美人鱼的图片 ，choose image and then save it。选择一张图片，然后把它保存下来。Let's open Sketchbook and then import the image。导入图片，并用两根手指把它移动到合适的位置。Drag the empty layer to the top and then choose color black。把空白图层挪到最上面，并选用黑色。Choose Technical Pen under Basic， 选择基本下面的针笔。Enable Predictive Stroke with Level 5 so you can draw a perfect circle。打开预测笔记，把级别升为5。Enable Symmetry Tool and then move the line to the middle of the circle。打开对称，并把对称线移到圆的中间。Lock the symmetry line so it won't move. 把对称线锁定，这样它就不会移动了。Draw a line to divide the circle horizontally. 画一条水平线，把圆形分成上下两部分。Locate the eyes and hairline. 给眼睛和发际线定一下位置。The neck and rectangular shaped body. 然后画脖子和长方形的身体。Stretch her slender arms to the horizontal line that we drew on top of the eyes. 两根细细的手臂要一直伸到眼睛上面的平行线处。Then draw her wavy hair. 然后画一下她大波浪一样的头发。Disable the symmetry tool to draw her tail and the fins. 把对称工具取消，来画她的鱼尾和鱼鳍。On each of the fin, one line has two curves.But the other line has one curve. 在每片鱼鳍上，你可以看到一条线上有两个弯，另外一条线上只有一个弯。The length of her head and her tail are roughly the same. 她头部的长度和尾部的长度大概是一样的。The length of her body and her fins are almost the same. 她的身体和尾鳍的长度大概也是一样的。But obviously her head and tail are longer than the body and the fins. 但是很显然，她的头部和尾部要比她的身子和尾鳍更长。Decrease the opacity of draft drawing layer to 5. Create a new layer on the top. 在上面新建一个图层。Increase the level of predictive stroke to 5. Enable symmetry tool and then click the button beside the lock button.To stop strokes at the center line, draw her eyes, eyelashes, face, ears. 画一下她的眼睛、睫毛、脸和耳朵。Then the hairline, nose, and mouth. 然后画一下发际线、鼻子和嘴。Then we draw her neck, arm, fingers, and body. 然后我们来画一下她的脖子、手臂、手指。和身体 ，She has a very narrow waist. 她的腰身很窄哦。Her bra is two shells with two gemstones. 她的胸被两片贝壳和两颗宝石覆盖。Her wavy hair can go through her arms and her tail. That's okay. 在画她大波浪一样的头发的时候，会穿过她的手臂和她的尾鳍，这是可以的。After draw her little skirt.We disable the symmetry tool. 画一下她的小裙摆，然后把对称工具取消。Finish up with her tail and the fins. 最后画一下她的鱼尾和鱼鳍。Connect all the gaps because we will fill in colors next. 把所有断开的地方都连上，因为我们下面要填色咯。Enable the fill tool from the top. 在上面打开填充工具。We need to enable sample all layers to have a proper fill from a different layer than the draft layer. 我们要打开对所有图层取样，这样才能在一个新的图层上面对草稿层进行填色。Press down your pen or your finger so you will see a target sign, and then move the target sign to the place that you want to take the color. 把你的笔或者手指使劲往下按一下。这样你就会看到一个靶子，把靶子移到你想取色的地方。Use the same method to fill in her tail, skirt, skin color, bra, and hair then eyes and mouth. 我们用同样的方法来填充它的尾鳍、小裙子、身体的颜色、胸部、眼睛和头发，还有嘴。Please make sure each part of her body is on a different layer. 她身体的每一部分都要在一个单独的图层上哦。Now we can delete the draft layers. 现在要把两个草稿图层都删掉。Switch back to technical pen and then start it from the fence layer to fill in the gap. 选用针笔，从最下面的尾鳍层开始，把缝隙填上颜色。We're going to repeat the same process from the bottom layer to the top layer one by one. 我们要用同样的方法从最底下的一层一层一层的画上去，直到最上面的一层。You press down your pen or finger to pick the color you're supposed to use for that particular layer. 你还是要按下你的手指或者你的笔来取色，用在合适的图层。Switch to yellow color Y02, 换成黄色 Y02. Enable predictive stroke with level 3, 打开预测笔记级别是3。Let's draw the decorative patterns all over her body on a new layer.我们要在一个新的图层上面，给她的身体上的各个部分都画上装饰性的花纹。Choose color white, 选择白色。Change the level of predictive stroke to 5, 把预测笔记的级别升到5。Please make sure the catch lights on her eyes are not symmetry but pointing to the same direction. 眼睛上白色的反光不要画对称哦，要画的朝向一个方向。Now let's Google underwater ocean clip art to find the background for our drawing. 我们现在来百度一张海底的卡通图片来做背景。After we import the background into sketchbook, you can use two fingers to resize the background. 我们把背景图片导入到 sketchbook 之后，你可以用两根手指把它放大缩小。Decrease the opacity of the background layer to 60.So the Little Mermaid is more obvious. 我们把背景图层的不透明度降为60，这样小美人鱼看起来更显眼一点。If you like the Little Mermaid we drew today, please don't forget to click like and subscribe. Thank you. 如果你觉得今天的小美人鱼画得还不错的话，给个一键三连里面的两个吧。